Yeah, thank you very much. A very warm good afternoon and namaste from Nepal. Respected Chairman, Excellencies, and participants from Southeast Asian countries, including China, I would like to extend my sincere thanks to the organizer for providing me this wonderful virtual platform. Just a minute. World has become a global village in the sense of growing connectivity and development. However, there are disparities among countries. Some of the countries has reached to the apex of prosperity, whereas other countries are suffering from acute penury. Developing countries like Nepal has its own problems. As a landlocked country, it has been facing many obstacles during natural calamities like earthquake and frequently imposing economic blockade by southern neighbor India. Single country dependency pushed Nepal to vulnerable condition during devastating earthquake 2015 and Indian economic blockade. Since Nepal had to seek an alternative means of connectivity and investment, Chinese President Xi Jinping's dream mega project under the name of One Belt, One Road as the continuation of Silk Road initiated by Han Dynasty came to existence, proposing to connect China with Asian and African countries through infrastructure development and investment. Nepal is a close neighbor, officially joined BRI in December 2014 after 7 months of the official proclamation of it in China on 14 May 2013. Known from different names like Silk Road projects, ODR and DRI, the highly ambitious project has been considered as the means of meeting the challenge of the time and rescuing developing countries like Nepal, Pakistan, Sri Lanka, Maldives, Afghanistan, Bhutan and Eurasian countries from destabilized economy. Since Nepal wanted to end single country dependency and develop its infrastructure, her involvement in BRI will be of great importance. China's ambition to connect Asia with Africa and Europe via land maritime networks through 6 corridors may not only benefit it, but also the partner countries through regional integration, economic growth, infrastructure development, and investment. China is the second biggest trade partner of Nepal, and there are only 2 trade routes, Tatopani and Rasuagadi Kerung at present. But no progress has been seen to open more routes to well already agreed and single both countries. The proposed rail routes like Kerung Kathmandu, Kathmandu Pokhara and Kathmandu Lumbini will change the overall economic scenario of Nepal if projects are launched and accomplished in determined time. It is obvious that through the proposed projects, not only the relations between the 2 countries, but also people-to-people relations will be further intensified at this opportunity. I would like to recall our Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli official visit and signing of Trans-Himalayan multi-purpose projects, as well as President Vidya Devi Bhandari's state visit to China during this period. Trans-Himalayan multi-dimensional connectivity network and Nepal-China cross-border railways are the most significant 2 projects being incorporated under VRI. To our pride, Chinese President Xi Jinping brief but historic visit of Nepal in 2019 not only opened a new era of understanding and cooperation between the 2 countries, but also got inspiration and courage from his promises China would help Nepal realize its dream of transforming itself from a landlocked country to a land-linked country. During his Nepal stay, he witnessed the signing of 20 agreements on including trans-Himalayan connectivity, security, energy, trade, and economic assistance. Prior to this, our president paid a state visit to China with a high-level delegation and participated in the second BRI summit on March 2019. During her visit, projects like 3 roads, 2 hydroelectricity plants, 1 cross-border railways, 1 cross-border transmission line, and 1 technical institute in the name of late People's Leader Madan Bhandari had been presented before China. I am hopeful that if we sincerely implement the agreements made between the 2 countries, they can be a game changer in our economic growth and development. It will obviously end Nepal's landlockedness as well dependency. So far, its impact in other South Asian countries is concerned. Without hesitation, I would like to mention that countries like Pakistan, Bangladesh, Bhutan, Vietnam, etc. For South Asian countries, BRI will be of great significance because China shares a 5,000 kilometers border with 5 South Asian countries, Nepal, India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, Bhutan, and Afghanistan. Some of the BRI projects have got momentum, like the China-Pakistan Economic Corridor, CPEC, the Bangladesh-China-India-Myanmar BCIM, linking BCIM to Lhasa, Kathmandu, and the Sinhai-Tibet Railway connecting to Kerung, Kathmandu, and Lumbini. These projects will certainly change the overall standard of people of the concerned countries.
Sorry to interrupt, my dear friend, Mr. Subhash Shankar Kandel. I'm sorry to interrupt.
Power generation and tourism industry, all of them need transportation access. Nepalese farmers faces a several loss during current pandemic of COVID-19. I trust China will support Southeast Asian countries in combating current pandemic COVID-19 under BRI countries. My organization, Center for Asian Policy Research and Studies, is carrying research in the field of BRI as well, better relation of South Asian countries as well as China. Very soon, we are going to publish a journal about current situation. Therefore, I would like to advise all to be sincere in implementation and completion of the projects. They will bring us together and provide us a good opportunity to share our common interest and experience. United, we can material our dream. Once again, I would like to thank the organizer for providing me this opportunity and expect the same programs in the days to come so that we can be more open and positive. I would like to extend my appreciation to Pakistan China Institute for organizing such an important program. And finally, before the COVID-19, I had an opportunity to meet Sri Lanka, to visit the Sri Lanka and Colombo. I have very much impressing over there what are happening in the Colombos. And last year I have paid the visit in Islamabad and some other places. I am very really impressed to cooperation with China and going to be a development. That's why we are, and as a media person also, me, we are initiating and every time knocking to our government to, without any hesitation, to cooperate with the China and very friendly nations to grow the development of Nepal and to upliftment of the poor peoples. That's why we are going to a new stage, and that's why all of us. And finally, I am thank you the this virtual platform and share my views, and our pain and our dream is same. That's why we are now traveling in the same boat, but we are staying in the different locations. And in the Nepal, you know, very geographically very crux location. That's why now the very much interesting and debating in international arena about the Nepal's. And already Professor Jayanathan describing so many things in the MCC and Americans and Indian Oceans and BRI. It's a very bitter fact. It is a bitter fact. That's why Nepal is also not in the 3 years before scenarios. Right now, Nepal is very different situation and different scenario and different strength. We have to do so many things. We have not no any hesitations, no any kinds of dependency to one nations. We have open up to the in northern frontier to China and southern frontier already India and also as well as Bangladesh, and we are trying to open up to the Myanmar also. That's why Nepal's future is in our collectively effort. Coming future will be brightful. That's why thank you very much, organizer and Senator Hussain and Pakistan China Institute. Once again, thank you very much.
Thank you very
much. Thank you very much, Mr. Kandel, for your very passionate speech. And certainly, we look forward.